Assalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh. Thank you to Dr. Salwahana for giving us the opportunity to do the financial analysis for a company, which is, the company we have chosen is YTL Corporation Berhad. So the one who going to present today is me, ASHIK. After that is YUSOF and Said, and after that finally will be the our brother ABDIQANI. So we choose YTL Corporation Berhad for our financial analysis ratio because YTL company is a corporation. Berhad is an investment holding and management company. So for your information, YTL is one of the Malaysia's biggest and most respected company because of their outstanding financial success. So they also have Francis Yeo who successfully lead the company through the recession. So for discuss about the financial ratios, who we divide into certain blocks, which is the first one is liquidity and efficiency, solvency and profitability. First of all, I'm going to discuss about the liquidity and efficiency. So the first ratio is current ratio, which is the short term, to measure the short term debt paying ability of the company. So a higher current ratio suggests a strong liquidity position. So we can see here in the formula, which is the current asset divided by the current liability. So we can see here in the statement here. So the 2013 we have 2.55 times, and in 2014 the current ratio is 2017. They have current ratio is around 1.84 times. This is shows that YTL Corporation Berhad has a healthy liquidity over those all 5 years to pay their short-term obligation, even through their current liability increase on 2017 significantly, which caused it to drop the current ratio. So we can see here in the graph, see it's increasing, then suddenly it's decreasing. Then after that is the account receivable turnover, which is the net sales divided by the average accounts receivable, which is to measure how many times a company converts its receivable into cash every year, each year. So back on the statement here, so we can see in 2014-13 is 7.25 times, and in 2017 it's 7.878 times. It shows the increasing. So based on the graph here, you see it's increasing 2014 into 2016, and it's slightly decreased on 2016 to 2017, which is because of the strict policy of collecting receivable and controlling them. So now I'm going to pass to our brother YUSOF to continue about the account means inventory turnover. Thank you.
Assalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh, Dr. Salwa. This is YUSOF. I'm going to talk about the next year, inshallah. So, inventory turnover. And inventory turnover is a ratio that shows how many times a company can sell and replace its inventory during a period. So, this is calculated by dividing the sales by average inventory. Also, the company can use this formula to calculate the days it can sell its existing or inventory on hand. So, if we go to LYT, its inventory turnover in 2014-13 is 17.3 times, which is quite good. This number keeps decreasing. 2015 it's 15 times, almost 16 times. 2016 is 14 times, and the best is 2017-2016, which is 13.56 times. And this shows the shareholders or the management that this company is doing well. The second, and also we look at the graph, you can see that it keeps on decreasing. The second one is account payable turnover. This ratio is a short time ratio, that measures direct accrued the company pays back its suppliers. This is calculated by dividing the cost of goods sold total purchase or total purchase divided by the average account payable. This shows the suppliers or future suppliers that this company can pay its obligations on time. If we go to LYT, it has a good turnover in 2013-2014, which is 7.49. In 2015-14, it decreases to 6.7 and it keeps on decreasing until it reaches 2017-5.82. If you see the graph, it keeps on decreasing, and this will make the suppliers wonder if this company can pay its rent, can pay its obligations on time. And the last one is the last one I'll talk about is the cash conversion cycle. This is the ratio that expresses the length of time that in days it takes a company to convert resources such as inventories into cash. This cash can be useful for comparing close competitors because the company with the lowest cash cycle is often with the better management. This determines how long it takes to create inventory, sell them in cash or invoices, collect that invoice, and also pay back the suppliers. If we go to YTL, the cash conversion in 2017 is 27 days. 2013 is 27, almost a month. But this number keeps on decreasing. In 2017, it goes to its lowest, which is 9 days. We can see this, but then increases a little bit until it reaches almost 12 in 2017, which is a very good number compared to other companies. This shows that this company has a good liquidity. It can turn its inventories or asset or current asset into cash. And that's all, Doctor. Assalamu alaikum. Now we will go to Saeed.
Hi, assalamu alaikum, Doctor Sawa. This is Saeed. I'm gonna explain about the total asset turnover. As you can see the formula, total asset turnover is equal to net sales divided by average total assets. So the asset turnover ratio is an important ratio that measures company's ability to generate sales from its total asset by comparing revenue with average total asset. Which means ratio shows how efficiently the company can use its asset to generate the sale. So as you can see the table here, the YTL company turnover shows 0.33 cents, 0.26 cents, 0.23 cents, 0.20 cents. It keeps decreasing from the 2014 to 2017. So this means YTL is having issues to increase the sale on contrast the sale is falling. The company needs to do more promotion, advertisement, and other making tools to increase their sales. And then next, I'm going to talking about the solvency, which is debt to equity ratio. As you can see, the formula is total liability divided by total equity is debt to equity ratio. So the debt to equity ratio shows the percentage of the company financing that comes from creditors and investors. So a higher debt to equity ratio indicates more creditor financing is used than investor financing. So as you can see here, the table and graph, companies with higher debt, company keep increase their higher debt. So in 2013, it was 70.13%, but it keep increase until 80% in 2017. which means the company have more risk and management have to try to minimize it. Thank you.
Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. Mr. Salwa, this is ABDIQANI OSMAN. I'm the next one to present the next ratio for my team. Our next ratio will be times interest earned ratio. This ratio is usually used to measure the ability of an organization to pay its debt obligation or interest obligations. So for our YTL company, actually the formula is income before interest and expense and income tax divided by interest expense. So if we go to our table for the 2013 to 2017, for YTL, the first 2 years have been very good, and they've been paying at 3.31 times, but the last 2 years have been decreasing, just like you can see the graph down here. It has not been good, and it's not good for taking loans in the future. Profitability margin, or just profitability or profitability margin, this is used to measure the profitability of a company using its assets, or let's say the profitability ratio used to measure the net income earned in each dollar that the company have in sales. We go to the table. It has been very constant. From 2013, it was 6%, but then it increased a little bit in 2014, and then it went back to its constancy in 2015, 2016, 2017. It's actually good if you can increase on your profit margin. For the companies, just see the graph right here, 2008 and 2014, and then all the way down again, constancy. If we go to our last ratio, which is return on total assets, it's a ratio to measure, it's a ratio that used to measure the net income produced by total assets during a period by comparing net income to the average total assets. So this is also means this is measure this measures how efficiently a company can manage its asset to produce profit during the years. So the return on total assets, if we go to figures and facts, we have a table. Back in 2013, it was 2014, we had 2.71%. After that, it decreased all the way to 1.15%, which is not good for the company. It's better that your return on total asset can always increase respectively. So that is our total ratios for our financial analysis assignment. I would say thank you to Dr. Salwahana for giving us opportunity to analyze our financial numbers. Thank you, doctor. Thank you so much.